And we are happy to have new Oilers GM Ken Holland joining us now to talk about this deal. Ken, there was a lot of talk about a change of scenery for both of these players after difficult seasons for each one. Why does James Neal make sense for Edmonton?
Well, he's a player, you know, I use the word the guy in the record book, and if you look at his resume and the guy in the record book, James Neal is a guy that scored 20-plus goals for 10 or 11 seasons. He had a tough year last year in Calgary, and we're hoping that coming to Edmonton with a new opportunity and, as you say, a change of scenery, that he can regain that scoring touch that he's had throughout his career.
Ken, you just mentioned the phrase record book. Well, if we're looking back in the record book, if you assembled one of the arguably the best teams ever in the National Hockey League, what difference is it now when you took over in 97 in Detroit to now we know about the salary cap? What are some of the hurdles and some of the different things that you got to deal with now becoming to Edmonton?
Well, obviously, you know, there's a limit what everybody can spend. It really, you know, if you look at what's happened since 2005 with when the salary cap came in, it really is, the parity in the league has never been better in the history of the National Hockey League. So, you know, you talk about the windows of opportunity. You know, lots of teams get those 2-3 year windows, and then the salary cap hits them. They're still good, but it eats away at your depth. So, I think the biggest difference is obviously there's a limit. There's a high and a low, and everybody has to be within that salary limit, and it's really added up to incredible parity in the National Hockey League.
Yeah, I'm sure you've seen a lot of change over the last couple of decades in your roles throughout the hockey world, and now as you enter a new phase, a new era in Edmonton, of course, with you as new GM, there's also a new coach in Dave Tippett. What have those early conversations been like with Tip about the identity of this team going forward?
Well, we've had lots of conversations. I think we both like speed. You know, if you look at the things that we've done this summer, we've tried to sign players that have got some pace to their game. We want to play up tempo. We want to try to get in the forecheck. We've signed some players from Europe, in Gaetan Haas down the middle and Nygaard. They're unknowns at the NHL level, but they play at the European level. They play with speed. We signed Archibald the other day, who played in Arizona. He can skate. We've signed Thomas Yerko, who we had in Detroit. He can play with pace. So we're trying to create some depth. We're trying to create some competition and some speed on the bottom part of the roster. The trade for James Neal is to try to bring in a player that on the top six is a guy that can play alongside either McDavid or Dreisaitl or Nugent Hopkins and provide some additional scoring. So we're trying to create, you know, a top six at two lines, so that you can't, if you shut down one line, maybe another line can produce for us. And we're trying to create some depth in the bottom part of the roster and some competition for jobs.
That's the at the NHL level. Can you speak to just how important the system is and how successful your system has been in the past and things that are kind of on the radar for what you need to do in the farm system for the Edmonton Oilers?
Well, I think you've hit it dead on. I think those teams that are really good in a salary cap area, they draft well, they develop well. When you look at the number of salary cap dollars the top players are demanding at the top part of the roster, if you want to have depth, you've got to find some cheaper players, or you've got to draft to develop those players, work their way on the roster, and they're good players for 2 or 3 years before they take a big jump in their salary. So you know, there's some, I'm fortunate, Peter Chiarelli and his staff has done a real good job. There's some really good defensemen here that down the road are going to really impact the Edmonton Oilers. Samarukov, a Russian player that played in Guelph, third-round pick. Bouchard, a first-round pick. He's turning pro, played in London last year in the OHL. We drafted this year Boberg in the first round, so we feel we've got some really good young defensemen that are going to be pushing their way onto the roster in the next 2 to 3 years. I've got there's some young Benson in the farm team has played real well at 66 points as a rookie in the American Hockey League. So there are some players there. I think one of the things that you always try to do is you try to acquire extra draft picks along the way, or trade back. Try to acquire more picks you can, because like I said, you need to You need to draft and you need to develop if you're going to be a good team with depth.
And Ken, of course, I think a big question for everyone with this team is in goal. With that situation, you guys signed Mike Smith, and of course, you still have Mikko Koskinen as well. How do you see the goalie situation playing out?
Well, Koskinen had a great, really good first half. The second half of the year when they were fighting for a playoff spot, I think Ken Hitchcock ran him out there like 22 or 23 nights in a row. And I think he hit the wall a little bit. Obviously, his first year in North American playing all that hockey is probably something he had never experienced before. Obviously, the schedules in Europe are nowhere near as long as the schedules in the National Hockey League. So, you know, we signed Mike Smith, and he's a Dave Tippett, our coach, knows him from Dallas days. They're both competitive guys. They both are big guys, and we're hoping that they can push one another on an everyday basis, and that we can that goaltending is going to be a strength for us.
Well, Ken, we certainly appreciate the time and the busy but also hopefully a little bit relaxing summer for you. Thanks so much for joining us, and good luck with the season moving forward.
Thank you very much.